गुड मॉर्निंग. टुडे लेट्स स्टार्ट विथ चैप्टर नंबर 13, दैट इज सरफेस एरियाज एंड वॉल्यूम्स. इन लोअर ग्रेड वी हैव लर्न व्हाट इज एरिया. एरिया इज अ स्पेस ऑक्यूपाइड बाय द सरफेस ऑफ द गिवन ऑब्जेक्ट. देन वी हैव लर्न एरियाज फॉर 2D शेप्स लाइक area of rectangle equal to length into breadth, area of square equal to length into length or L square, area of triangle equal to half base into height, etc. Such similar 2D shapes areas we have already learned. Now here we will study areas of 3D shapes. Now first, surface areas of cuboid and a cube. Let's see 3D shapes one by one and their respective surface areas. First, cuboid. A bundle of many sheets of paper looks like a cuboid. When we look at the given figure, we can see that a single sheet of paper is in a rectangular shape, or you can say a 2D shape. But when we pile up many such sheets of paper, we get a shape which looks like a cuboid. So, cuboid is a rectangular solid bounded by 6 rectangular plane faces. For example, a book, a brick, a shoebox, etc. You know that when we are piling up, we are keeping one upon another many sheets of paper, we will get a shape which looks like a cuboid. Now, this cuboid has 6 rectangular plane surfaces or plane faces. In 2D shapes, we have 2 dimensions, that is length and breadth. Now in 3D shape, another dimension is included, that is height. Therefore, a cuboid is a 3-dimension shape, that is called 3D shape. That is, it has 3 different dimensions, that is length, breadth and height. Moreover, cuboid has 6 rectangular faces, 12 edges and 8 vertices. You can see in the figure that what are edges, what are vertices, what are faces, and length, breadth and height. Already it is, you can see when this is your length, this is your breadth and this is your height. Yes, similarly you can see the faces, edges and vertices. So a cuboid is has 6 rectangular faces, 12 edges and 8 vertices. Now, what is a net of a cuboid? Net is nothing but when we open the given shape, what form is it takes, that is called net. So when we open a cuboid, we get a net in this shape. Means you can see in the figure that we get 6 rectangular plane surfaces. So a cuboid is made up of 6 rectangular plane surfaces. Here you can see in the figure 1, 2, this is your number 3 red one, again number 4 blue one, up yellow one 5 and down yellow one 6. These are all plane surfaces. Plane means they are 2D only, they have 2 dimensions. Now what is surface area, or you can say it as a total surface area? It is written in short as TSA. A measure of the total area that the surface of the object occupies is called surface area of a solid. Means surface area is nothing but sum of the, yeah, you can say total of the areas of the whatever surfaces the object have. means in cuboid we have 6 rectangular surfaces. So when we add the area of these 6 rectangular plane surfaces, it will be the surface area. So the sum of areas of all the 6 faces of a cuboid is known as its total surface area, which is written in short as TSA. You can see in the figure that net of cuboid is shown, which is made up of 6 different rectangular plane surfaces which are having two different dimensions. Already the numbering of the rectangle is given with the two dimensions. Therefore, total surface area of a cuboid equal to sum of areas of 6 rectangular faces. Now we can see that 6 rectangular faces. Now number 1 rectangular face has length and height. Number 2 has length and breadth. 3 has again length and height, because in cuboid opposite sides are equal and parallel. Similarly in 4 again it is length and height. These are all called walls of a cuboid. And then it has one top and one bottom. Top and bottom are also equal, so they have number 5 and 6 both have breadth and height. Yes. So we write further that you will get 2 times, that is length into breadth. Here we have taken length into breadth 1 time, again length into breadth 2 times. Similarly, plus breadth into height, that is top, and another breadth into height, that is bottom. Again length into height, one of the wall and another opposite wall, again length into height. So we write length into breadth plus length into breadth plus breadth into height plus breadth into height plus length into height plus length into height. That will we will get equal to 2 times length into breadth plus 2 times breadth into height plus 2 times length into height. Now in all the 3 terms you can see that 2 is common. So further solving we will get total surface area of a cuboid equal to 2 common, that is twice length into breadth plus breadth into height plus length into height square units, because always area is denominated in square units only. So we write TSA of a cuboid equal to twice LB plus BH plus LH square units. This is the first formula for your cuboid. Next is lateral surface area. In short, it is written as LSA. Now what is the lateral faces first? The 4 faces which meet the base of a cuboid are called the lateral faces of the cuboid. Means we have top and bottom of a cuboid. So the 4 faces which stands on the bottom of a cuboid are called lateral faces. In short, for lateral faces you have to exclude the top and bottom rectangular face. Hence, the sum of areas of the 4 walls of a cuboid is called lateral surface area. Yes, you can see in the figure that we don't have to count this top and bottom. This you don't have to count. Only we have to count the 4 walls, that is 1, 2, 3 and 4. We have to count these areas of this 4 wall summation. That will be your lateral surface area. Suppose that if a room with a ceiling is given, so if we don't count the ceiling and the floor of the room, only if we count the 4 walls of the room, that is called lateral surface area. Therefore, LSA of the cuboid equal to sum of areas of the 4 walls of a cuboid. That is equal to, now you can see that 4 walls are what? Length into height plus length into height plus length into breadth plus length into breadth. These are the 4 walls area. That is equal to, we will get 2 times length into height plus 2 times length into breadth. that is equal to 2 times length into height plus 2 times breadth into height. Again we can see that we can take out 2 common, so further solving we write therefore LSA, that is lateral surface area of a cuboid, equal to 2 times length plus breadth into height. 2 is also common and height is also common. What we write is as formula as twice L plus B in bracket into height square units. Why we are mentioning height behind the bracket? Because twice L plus B is nothing but a perimeter of a rectangle. And you know that the base of a cuboid is nothing but a perimeter of a rectangle. So we can also write or lateral surface area of a cuboid equal to perimeter of the base into height. This twice L plus B is nothing but perimeter. Either you can take as the base, because sometimes in the question it may be asked for the base, sometimes it may be asked for the ceiling also. So this is twice L plus B, and height we mention it as separately as height. This perimeter of the base, this is the formula for perimeter of base, and this is our height. So we can take the formula of LSA of a cuboid in two forms, but general formula for LSA of cuboid is twice L plus B into height square units. Another is the diagonal of a cuboid. We all know that diagonal is the line segment joining the opposite vertices. So here also the line segment joining opposite vertices is called the diagonal of a cuboid. Now the formula to find out the diagonal of a cuboid is diagonal of a cuboid equal to under root L square plus B square plus H square units, because here we are finding the diagonal, and diagonal has only one dimension, so we write it as in simple without power unit. Now actually diagonals are 4 for a cuboid. Yeah, you can say cuboid has 4 equal diagonals. All the diagonals of a cuboid are equal. So if we want to find the diagonal of a given cuboid, we use the formula under root L square plus B square plus H square. So this is the third formula which is useful to solve the questions related to cuboid. So we have learned TSA, that is total surface area, then LSA, that is lateral surface area, and diagonal formulas. Next, another 3D shape is cube. We all know the shape of cube. So what is cube? A cuboid whose length, breadth and height all are equal is called a cube. You know that cube, the difference between cube and cuboid is this only, that all the edges of a cube are equal. So we write in the form of that it is also a cuboid, but it is a cuboid where length, breadth and height all are equal. For example, dice, sugar cubes, Rubik's cube, etc. A cube also has 6 square faces, 12 edges and 8 vertices. In cuboid, we also have same 6 faces, but all the 6 faces were rectangular. Here also there are 6 faces, but faces are square. Similar 12 edges in both and 8 vertices in both. You can see in the figure what are the edges, what are the vertices and what are the faces of a cube. Similarly, the 3 dimension, as the cuboid has 3 dimension, length, breadth and height. Here also it has 3 dimension, length, breadth and height. But all these 3 dimensions remains equal. That is, we write each edge of a cube have same length. Means sides of a cube are equal in length. Now net of a cube When we open a cube, we get a net in this way. This is a pic of a Rubik's cube. You know that Rubik's cubes have 6 different colors. So we get different 6 squares faces. All the 6 faces of a cube are congruent square faces. Now, all these 6 faces of cube are congruent square faces. Congruent, remember the word congruent, meaning that objects which are equal in shape and size are called congruent. So the 6 faces of a cube are congruent square faces. Now surface area of a cube . So total surface area of a cube equal to sum of areas of 6 faces. It is similar like TSA of cube. There also it was sum of areas of 6 rectangular faces. Here, as all the faces are square, we have sum of areas of 6 square faces. You can see in the figure that as all the edges have the same length, we have taken the length as A. So the area of each square face will become A square. Here you can see that area of this first square will become A square, because A into A, that is A square. Similarly here, A into A, that is A square. A into A square, A into A, A square. A into A, A square. Here also A into A square. So we get 6 times summation of A square. That is A square plus 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 A square. Therefore, total surface area of a cube equal to 6 A square units. This is the formula to find out the TSA of a cube. Next is the lateral surface area of a cube, that is LSA. Again, lateral surface area means you have to count the area of the 4 walls only. So LSA, yeah, you can write lateral surface area of a cube equal to sum of area of 4 faces, that is equal to A square plus A square plus A square plus A square. Here you can see that we have to count only these 4 walls. This is 1, 2, 3, and this is 4th one. So we have to count area of 4 walls. This again, top and bottom is not included in lateral surface area, as I have said before. So we write A square plus A square plus A square plus A square, that will be equal to 4A square. Therefore, the formula to find out lateral surface area, yeah, LSA of a cube equal to 4A square units. Again, area is always written in square units. Now the formula to find out the diagonal of a cube is, we write diagonal of a cube equal to under root A square plus A square plus A square, that is equal to under root 3A square. Therefore, diagonal of a cube equal to under root 3A, because A square and square root cut, so we get A. So we write diagonal of a cube equal to under root 3A units. These are the formulas which you have to memorize so that we can apply it in our given questions. Now, units of measurement of area and volume. Here, area is related to length only. So, first we learn the table for length only. So, length, you can see the table, which again you have to memorize. This all we have learnt in lower grade. Then also once, 1 centimeter equal to 10 millimeter. Millimeter is the smallest unit of length, which we have to learn right now. So 1 centimeter equal to 10 millimeter. Then greater to millimeter is centimeter, then greater to centimeter is decimeter. So we write 1 decimeter. In short, decimeter is written as dm equal to 10 centimeter. Then we have 1 meter. This is given in increasing order. 1 meter, meter in short is written as m equal to 10 decimeter equal to 100 centimeter equal to 1000 millimeter. Again, then we have 1 decameter equal to, decameter in short is written as dam equal to 10 meter equal to 1000 centimeter. Then comes hectometer, so we write 1 hectometer in short it is written as hm equal to 10 decameter equal to 100 meter. And last is the highest unit for length, that is 1 kilometer, which is written as km in short equal to 1000 meter equal to 100 decameter equal to 10 hectometer. This table you have to remember because in questions sometimes we have to convert the units. So it is necessary to remember the conversion table. Yes, dear students, please copy all this in your regular CW. Thank you.